everybody. Wanted to record a quick virtual field trip. Just take a couple of minutes, hopefully, to get through this. I'm at the mouth of the Smith River on the Wild Rivers coast of Northern California, located between the cities of Brookings, Oregon, and Crescent City, California. We're about a mile and a half, maybe 2 miles from the border between Oregon and California, right on the coast. And this is the Pacific Ocean right here, and this is the Smith River. So my head is actually right where the mouth, right where the water comes in. And it's a home to an extraordinary variety of life. There's, of course, a large amount of fish that live here in a wide variety, because you have freshwater varieties that could live over here, and then you have saltwater varieties that could live over here, and then there's varieties that can go between the two, that can go into what we call brackish water and survive in those environments as well. And because of that diversity, there's also a diversity of hunters. There's sea otters. I've actually seen sea otters swimming over here on this side, and then over here there's sea lions actually lurking in the water. In fact, I wouldn't be surprised if one did poke up over my shoulder here during this recording. They've been actually out there frolicking and having a good time and hunting for the last 10 minutes before I even started recording. So what's happening here is we have the ocean. This is sea level. This is the place where the Smith River is trying to get to. It's bringing a lot of water. Remember, if you've seen my previous video on the Smith River, you know that it's clean water. Most of this water can be drank without getting any illness. And it's also carrying large amounts of rocks and sand and silt with it. In that previous video, we saw that the average cobble size on the banks of the Smith River up in the mountains was about 7-8 inches, but it could get as large as about 24 inches. I mean, it could get very large. Down here, they're much smaller. They've been worked over, they've been chipped away as they've been transported down the Smith River several miles. And as they've gotten down here and chipped away, it's produced another thing that is less common, and that is sand, right? We have sand down here. And this sand is actually derived from the chippings. It's the breaking up of the these rocks as they're being transported down. So that sand will make its way into the Pacific Ocean. That wave action right there will then push that sand, start forcing it right along that beach, and it'll actually create this beach. There's so much sand, in fact, coming out that there's a continual and wind current that's coming off the ocean towards the land, and it's even not only just washing the sand, it's also blowing it and forming sand dunes. And so this spit of sand that we see that's dividing the Smith River from the Pacific Ocean is the tip of something called the Tolowa Sand Dunes, which goes for quite some distance, all the way from where I'm located right now, all the way to the city of Crescent City. And this was a place where the Tolowa culture resided for, I don't know the exact duration, but they were here for a very long time. They were the native inhabitants to this region. And there's still a lot of archaeological work being done in those dunes. All right, with that said, thanks for sitting through this. I hope you enjoyed this little visit to the Smith River and where it dumps into the Pacific Ocean in Northern California. Take care.